Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Sanket Pisat. I am a consultant gynecological laparoscopic surgeon working in Andheri in Mumbai. And today we are going to talk about endometriosis. Endometriosis, as you may have heard from newspapers or reports, is a disease that affects the reproductive tract of females quite commonly. The incidence of endometriosis has been increasing in the past few years, mainly attributed to a late age of marriage, a late age of pregnancy, or sometimes because of having no children at all. So what is actually endometriosis? Endometriosis is the abnormal growth of the uterine lining, which should normally be growing within the uterus at places where it should not be growing, like on the other organs within the abdominal cavity, for example on the ovaries. What happens is that this endometrial lining causes pockets of blood filled tissue on other organs like the ovaries or the intestines and results in tremendously painful periods to the patient, also sometimes resulting in infertility. The diagnosis of endometriosis is largely clinical in the sense that a sequelae or a set of symptoms commonly suggest that you may be suggesting from endometriosis. These include very heavy periods, tremendously painful periods, or an onset of pain just before the periods but going away as the periods start, or sometimes just plainly infertility. Other times in some patients, it may be a difficulty in sexual intercourse or pain during sexual intercourse, and all of these require intensive investigation. Sometimes endometriosis can be diagnosed by an ultrasound examination in which the cysts in the ovary show the presence of endometriosis, and then these are the patients who require surgery. Endometriosis surgery nowadays can be done by laparoscopy or minimally invasive surgery, in which there are hardly 3 or 4 cuts taken on the abdomen which are less than a centimeter in size, and the entire disease of endometriosis can be removed by surgery through these 3 or 4 ports. Of course, some pockets of endometriosis which are attached to vital organs within the body may not be removed, but these can then be managed by medicines alone. In other patients in whom endometriosis is not as widespread, the entire disease can be controlled by medicines alone, and the patient can be given long-term therapy for about 3 months or 6 months to make sure that the endometriosis stays quiescent and does not grow again. A word of caution for these patients, particularly patients with endometriosis who are also suffering from infertility, is that it is essential to plan pregnancy and childbirth early, because endometriosis is a disease of recurrence and a disease of progression, and as age advances and endometriosis increases in intensity, it becomes more and more difficult to conceive either naturally or by any form of assisted reproductive techniques. If you have any further questions in this regard, please feel free to contact me via Librate. Thank you.